Welcome back, amigos. Camille Damen, Dive in Life, Lessons in Life. I'm going to talk about Grain Scanner today. Grain Scanner is an amazing tool. You can, it's sort of like a granular synth, like the other one that Robert Henke made for Ableton, the Granulator. And I think it was earlier this year or maybe already last year, it was released, the Grain Scanner. It's an extension pack that you can find here in packs. If you've purchased it, I think it's about $50. Sometimes they have a discount, mostly with Black Friday, which we just had actually. But you know, check out Grain Scanner. We're going to talk about it today. I'm going to show you how to make crazy vocals with Grain Scanner. Before we do this, check out my courses. I've got beginner, intermediate, and advanced courses starting in January with a few spots left. So if you want to have me as a teacher instead of just watching my videos, check it out. It's 8 weeks courses or 4 weeks courses, depending on which one you choose. And it's a lot of fun. And I take you through all these things and you can ask questions and you get free samples and you get a 30 minutes private lesson, all this stuff. So check it out. There's also on the website sample packs and preset packs that you can get. Some are free, some are paid. There's some masterclasses as well. And on the YouTube, you will find me interviewing artists, established artists from all kinds of sounds. And sometimes we do feedback sessions on YouTube and Twitch on the Wednesdays as well. So check out all that we do. Anyway, here's the new tutorial about Grain Scanner. So let me put the Grain Scanner on the MIDI, because it's a MIDI instrument. And I'm going to run you through all the options that it has, or the ones that are pretty explainable, because granular synthesis can go pretty deep actually. And I've recorded a piece of vocal here on Audio 3, which is pretty nice. It's like me speaking a sentence, and I will drop it into the Grain Scanner and then work with it. Let me check, because my system, there we go, there's the Grain Scanner. It's a bit slow today, I don't know, maybe I've been recording too much tutorials. So here we have the Grain Scanner. It comes also with a lot of presets that you can actually try, which are really, really nice. But I'm going to use this. This is my voice. Lessons in Life tutorial live. Yeah. So I'm going to use this and we're going to actually drop that in. So if you've recorded something like this, you can just drag it onto Grain Scanner. And there it is. Now if I play a note, and the cool thing from a granular synthesizer is that you can have it scan through what you recorded. So the scan guy, if I move this a bit to the right, it's going to slowly move. And the more I do it, the faster it goes. And I can also say, you know, the duration of each little grain, because granular synthesis just chops the sound up in all these little grains, which you can control the duration from. So watch what happens. And if you make it super short, so if we keep it quite short and we add some layers, which is sort of like unison on a synth, and then it will go all the way to the end. And because I selected this option here with the scan, it goes back. So it's a bit scary. So you can play around with it and get all these super interesting effects. You got also, you can here put the key follow, and then it's actually, it gets a bit more like a robot. I prefer this one. And you can also say, I just want to have this section. So you can just click and say, I just want to have this. So I just want to say, maybe I just want to work on Lessons in Life. And it now goes back and forth. I can multiply the speed. And then play with the layers. It's fucking crazy. So you can do all these things with it. And so the layers are more like unison. You can also add a random variation, the same for the position. Position is where it starts in here. So if I've selected this, it usually starts at the beginning, but I can also make it start later. And randomize that. So it will always start from a different position. You can also make it go only forward. So let's make it a bit slower again. Let's do it on one. And then you can also have it go and stop, which is pretty cool. We can use some reverse. Some grains will then be reversed. You can use pen variation. You can say, okay, what's the chance of the grain playing? So it's going to be a bit less busy. Less is in life. That's pretty cool. I like it a bit more here. It's so super cool. The M variation, I never use it. I guess you can here variation in decibels of the grain amplitude. Some will be a bit softer and louder. Nice. Another thing which is cool, I like the Gauss one, where you can actually let's play this. Let's put the chance up. So now you can make this really short. So big is this. To make the grains really short, which creates more of a stutter effect. Cool, right? You can play chords. So that's pretty cool. Yeah, I can go really crazy. Okay, so this is a bit like what you can do with it with a vocal. And there's some other stuff as well. You got an envelope, of course. Then it will come up slowly. Well, you all know what like envelopes do, I hope. If not, follow my beginner's course, please. There's a filter. You got to put the dry wet up. You got resonance. And we have the envelope modulator. There's also morph, which you know from Ableton. There's the distortion. And if you put it on excite, it's going to excite everything above this split frequency, or everything below this split frequency as a saturator. There's reverb with a lot of reverb reflection. Oh, right, here we go. Which is pretty cool. There's a matrix, and this is especially cool because the filter resonance for the filter frequency, for instance, I can assign to mod number one. I can either create a sign. I have to like assign it here on the side. And besides that, we can also put it to a step and create it. So we can step sequence sort of like the filter on the you don't see it moving, but it's so you can create amazing things with this device. Of course, you can also add other sounds in there. You don't necessarily have to use vocals, but I thought I'd showed you Grain Scanner. I really like it for vocals to make them stutter and do crazy stuff. Maybe you want to add something else or record your mom and put your mom into the Grain Scanner and see what comes out. It's pretty fun. So I hope this inspires you. Make sure to practice this. You know, if you get Grain Scanner, good choice. You can also use the granulator, which is actually also here. Granulator, maybe cool to show. Granulator, granulator 2. It's cool. It's different. I do like Grain Scanner more, to be honest. But in essence, they're basically the same thing. You have your cycle, you know, which is pretty much like your scan. You have your grains, file position, you know, the same thing. You can change it to you have the attack. You also have the same. You have the filter. It's pretty much the same, but it looks a bit different. And to be honest, it's a bit buggy here and there. Sometimes my computer crashes, so I'm happy I could open it. Anyway, go for it. Have fun. And I'll see you at the next tutorial.